We will consider a particle whose rest mass is m0 or m0, and whose electric charge is q. And we just want to know how this particle will move if it is found in some kind of electric and magnetic fields. And we haven't defined these fields yet, because we want to construct, we want to build the theory. But we know in general that if we want to find some laws, we have to start from some axioms or some empirical evidence. And the empirical evidence that we are going to use is that, okay, we know that there can be some fields, which can be either electric or magnetic fields, and how can we give some meaning to these fields? For instance, we can start from the Lorentz law, where the force that's acting on the particle is equal to the electric charge times the electric field plus the charge times the velocity of the particle cross the magnetic field. So this is the famous Lorentz law. And of course, the force is equal to the rest mass of the particle times the derivative of the velocity with respect to time. And let me stress here that we are going to consider classical physics for now. At least for now, we are going to consider classical laws. That means that the velocity of the particle is much smaller than the speed of light, which I will denote by c. So the famous constants that we are going to use in the theory are the mass, the rest mass, the charge, and we can also introduce the speed of light, c. Let me say that if you want to know how the particle is moving in some kind of fields, in general, what we want to do is to define a Lagrangian associated to the particle. And in classical physics, since we are going to consider very small velocities here, we can just consider for the Lagrangian the classical expression. And the classical expression, we already saw that in my course on special and general relativity, but you should know this if you have studied some Lagrangian mechanics. This is equal to the kinetic energy that I denote by the capital T, minus the potential energy that I denote by using the letter V. Or if you want, you can also rewrite this as kinetic energy plus the potential. This is not the potential energy, this is just the potential. So the potential is just minus the potential energy, by definition, and it has to do with the work, with the concept of work, which is generated by the forces acting on the particle in this case. So if you know the definition of U, and in particular the differential of U, this is just the sum of the forces, let's say, acting on the particle, that I will denote by Fj, dot product with the infinitesimal displacements of the particles. If you have more particles, each of these forces act on each and every particle, then we have the sum of Fj dot dxj, let's say, the displacements of the single particle constituting our system. In this case, it's just some kind of discrete system or a system of discrete forces. But this is not something that we are going to need right now. In classical physics, we know that the kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 the mass of the particle. In this case, we only have one particle times the square of the speed of the particle, or the velocity squared, if you want, which we can also denote as v squared. The this is the magnitude of the velocity squared, of course. But if you remember, in general, when we want to find some laws, we want to derive them in such a way that they are covariant, meaning that they do not change from one reference frame to another frame. And why this? Well, I explained this thoroughly in the course related to special and general relativity, but let me say this here as well. We know that from Galileo's principle in classical mechanics, the laws of physics remain the same in inertial frames. Einstein went beyond that and said that all laws of physics should have the same form, should preserve the same form in every reference frame, not just inertial frames, but all inertial and non-inertial frames. We want to find covariant laws. Covariant means that we want to find laws that do change, but only according to some specific laws in physics. And these laws are tensor laws. So if you want to use tensor notation, I mean, this is not written in tensor notation. When we want to use tensor notation in physics, we need not vectors, but four vectors. If we define the four vector of velocity, x dot mu, let's say, when we use Greek letters in physics, we mean that these indices range from 0 to the value 3. So 0, 1, 2, and 3. So we have four possible values. When we talk about velocity in general, we speak about the three-dimensional velocity, so it only has three components: the first component, the second component, and the third component. We don't have the time component, which is the zero component. So we have to associate to this x dot mu here also a metric, a four-dimensional metric. In the case of three-dimensional components, this metric was the Kronecker delta, so we only had delta ij. This is the identity matrix, just 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. So all zeros of the diagonal. When we talk about four vectors, we need to consider the four-dimensional tensor era mu nu, which is given by 1 on the first component, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and then all zeros of the diagonal, right? I will not write all zeros. If you know something about special relativity, this is the Lorentz metric. It has to do with the Lorentz transformations. And if we want to use this notation, if I multiply x dot mu by era mu nu times x dot nu, just like this. So remember that in this case, I'm going to sum over repeated indices. And when I say repeated, they have to be one in the lower position and another one in the upper position. So in here, we are going to sum over mu and over nu. So I'm going to use Einstein's summation convention. And this is equal to just x dot zero squared. And then we get these minus signs here. So for the first component, the second component, and the third component, I get a minus sign. So I get minus the velocity squared, because it's the velocity squared is just x dot one squared plus x dot two squared plus x dot three squared. In particular, I can also rewrite this as x dot mu, x dot lower mu. Because by definition, when I multiply a tensor by some four vector, x dot, let's say, nu, I just lower its index and I just define this as x dot mu. So v squared is just equal to x dot zero squared minus x dot mu times x dot mu, just like this. Or remember, x0, the zero coordinate, is the coordinate that is related to time. This x dot zero, this component, should be an invariant quantity, because we want to find an invariant form of the Lagrangian, and x0 is equal to the speed of light times time. So if the velocity of the particle is much smaller than the speed of light, when we take the derivative, we get that x dot zero is equal to the speed of light c. So in here, we get v squared is just equal to c squared minus x dot mu times x dot mu. And this is invariant. So if you want to be very rigorous when you talk about electromagnetism in general, you should know tensors, you should know Lagrangian mechanics, and also you should know special relativity. Because it has very much to do with special relativity. So since electromagnetism was derived before special relativity, this wasn't the approach that was used in the derivation, because at that time people didn't know anything about special relativity, and still through the use of experiments and some mathematics also, people like Maxwell were able to consistently derive the equations of classical electromagnetism. But it was very difficult at that time, because they didn't even have the right notation to write the equations concisely. So Maxwell wrote down lots of equations, like components by components. They didn't even have vector notation. It took some time. Heaviside was the one that made Maxwell's theory of electromagnetism much more concise. But anyway, so if we want to write the expression for kinetic energy in tensor notation, we can rewrite this as 1 half m0 times c squared minus 1 half m0 times x dot mu, just like this. Then we need to derive the potential energy. We need to define some kind of potential energy. And I will do this in the next video, because otherwise this one will get too long.